Hello, I'm Matt Dunwell and I'm based at Ragmans Lane Farm in Gloucestershire. And it's a 60-acre farm, and on that farm we have about 1,000 apple trees. So in this session I'd just like to be talking a bit about how we're growing the trees, the lessons that we've learned, some of the experiments that we're doing, and a little bit about marketing, and let's have a look around the orchard and I'll show you what we're up to. This is a Blenheim orange tree, and it's a good example of how we're trying to manage our trees here at Ragmans. We've got quite a spaced out planting, 3 meters by 5 meters. And that means that there's lots of air under the canopy for a natural control of fungal diseases. The more air you've got running through the trees, the more they can fight that off. So how you plant your trees is important in terms of natural pest and disease control. The other way that we control disease and pests is by supporting the tree with the use of a probiotic approach. In other words, what we're doing is instead of poisoning the tree with copper and sulfites, which is how most commercial orchards go about their business, we spray the tree with something called aerated compost tea. So that's a preparation made out of compost, which we then put into a liquid form, and we spray it on the leaves and the branches and the roots and the soil around the tree. And what that does is it coats the tree in a beneficial thatch of very, very small microbes that will then protect it against any disease that comes in, airborne or soil-borne disease. And that will ensure that the crop is pretty healthy, it's almost pristine, and it hasn't got any chemicals on it, which, you know, apples are sprayed an awful lot. So one of the things we're interested in at Ragmans is apples that look great to eat, but we're not particularly concerned about producing supermarket apples that are absolutely perfect. You can see there's a mark here, and what we're interested in is trying to educate the people that are buying the apples into seeing that this apple, with its few imperfections, is actually has got more nutrition in it than an apple that looks perfect but has been sprayed with copper or sulfite, or even with conventional chemicals. Our apples are basically unsprayed with poisons. They're only sprayed with compost tea and a bit of comfrey liquid as well to help the fruit. So we're here in the orchard with a patch of hybrid willow, and you might be thinking, what is this willow doing in an orchard? This is some willow that was planted last year, and this is 1 year's growth. It's about 15 feet tall. What willow does really well is it photosynthesizes and it fixes carbon dioxide out of the atmosphere really, really fast. Massive amounts of transpiration and growth. And what we can do with this material is cut it every year. It has a massive biomass yield, and then we chip it into small wood chips and we use it as a mulch under the trees. And this is called a rameal wood chip. It's actually the tips of the, it's very small branches, and they have a relatively high protein content compared to other wood chip. So they rot down really quickly. But also the other story is, where you've got this sort of agroecological growing going on, where you're not using lots of industrial inputs, you've got to make sure that you can get your inputs from local sources. So this is sunlight, intelligent planting, and then chipping it down and composting it under the trees. And the protein and the carbon that's fixed by the willow is then taken into the soil and reinforces the soil food web, all the microorganisms that are actually working to provide nutrition for the trees under the ground. So I'm standing in here now to give you an idea of how tall they are, and hopefully you can get an idea of the height. They grow over an inch a day when they're really going for it. So it's a productive little area. So all this stuff is now chipped down and composted, and we're going to go and look and see how it looks on the ground around the trees. Okay, so now we get down on the ground, and I'm going to show you what's going on down here. So these are some wood chips that we put down a year ago, and you can see already you've got a really nice sort of, this smells of oyster mushrooms, and in fact they've been inoculated with oyster, and that helps the chip rot down. But it also, what the chip is doing is it's forming this really nice blanket over the soil, so that the soil here, even though we've been dry now for about 3 or 4 weeks, is really nice and moist. It's got this sort of duvet over the top of it, a sort of blanket keeping it warm and wet. The other thing that's happening here is that the chip is creating a fungal environment. It's actually mimicking like a woodland floor, and the soil microbes that are now getting established under this tree are microbes that are predominantly interested in fungal environments. And what that means is it actually it cuts back on the amount of grass around the trees. So what you get is a predominance of broadleafed plants around the trees, and into that we planted comfrey. This is Bocking 1-4. And that will actually compete with the wood chip against the grass very, very well. And what the comfrey's doing is sending its roots down really deep into the soil, far deeper than an apple tree's roots will go. And it's scavenging for all the nutrients and minerals that are beyond the root horizon of the apple tree. And it's pulling those back up into its leaves. And every two or three times a year, we'll come through with a scythe and we'll just cut and drop the comfrey leaves around the apple trees. And that helps cycle the nutrients and the minerals back up to within the root zone of the apple tree. Okay, so this is what we do. I mean, on a big scale, obviously we're doing it with a scythe, but just to demonstrate, this is cut and drop with comfrey. And it's what comfrey loves. Comfrey loves to be cut, and then it grows back again with new leaves. So don't be worried about the comfrey. No comfrey plants were harmed in the making of this video. But now you've got a tree that's got a nice layer of wood chip underneath. It's got the nutrition that it wants on top of the wood chip that's going to work its way down, and it's all been grown and produced on farm. Okay, so hopefully that's a very brief introduction into what we're doing here at Ragmans with our trees. I think the essence of it is that we're trying to grow a commercial crop without the use of loads of expensive inputs. And the way that we're doing that is by experimenting with a lot of natural fertility and natural pest control. So I would recommend this as a technique at home if you're doing this. It keeps your costs down, but most of all, you're producing deeply nutritious food, which is what it's all about in the long run. Thank you.